Good Monday morning. You're watching a series where we explore iterators, and today we're going really bananas. We're going to explore higher order iterators. So in the same way that we have higher order functions to manipulate arrays such as map and filter and reduce, we can also build that for asynchronous iterators. That is what we are going to do today. I am MPJ and you are watching Fun Function. Today's show is sponsored by Pusher! Pusher makes it painless to add real-time collaboration and communication features to your app. Chat, PubSub, feeds, you name it. Check them out at pusher.funfunfunction.com. That link is also in the episode description. Big disclaimer, it's summer in Sweden, which is amazing because it's now bright outside and the birds are chirping, but it's also very warm and the air conditioning is not working and I have to close the doors and put on the lights when I'm recording this. So you might see me becoming gradually more and more sweaty as the video progresses, and at some point I might die. But then again, then it would be weird who uploaded the video. Anyway, higher order iterators. Let's have a look where we were last time. Let's go to this nice channel called Fun Function and look at the last episode. And hang on, code from the episode. Well, it's broken here, so we need to get a new API key. I'm clicking this link here. Then we come on, let me scroll. Come on, let me scroll. And then yeah, let's click this do not sign call and then call method. Scroll down, click this link here, and I guess steal this API key here. It will hopefully be expired by the time you view this video. Let me go back to the code and paste this API key in there. Off. Alright, to remind you, like, this is this infinite stream of images. Supposedly cats, but there's some nasty pigs that have snuck their way in there. Now, let's have a look at this Flickr tag search here. I won't be delving too much into this code because I've talked about it in the previous episode. By the way, if you're just jumping into this video, you're gonna be confused. If you wanna watch the full series playlist, you can do so here. In addition to the series, if you're not familiar with the concept of higher order functions, then there's a big chance that this is going to confuse the hell out of you, and I'm kind of assuming that you're sort of familiar with them. If you're not, I luckily have a video series on that too, in the higher order functions video, and then a accompanying playlist there as well, that you might want to check out. That link is also in the episode description. Like all the links. Anyway, let's have a look at this code. The thing I want to draw your attention to is this await delay thing here, because I added that because if I don't, yeah, you'll see, like, it just becomes we want the stream to be sort of not crazy and just not be too eagerly fetching images. So what it does is that every time it gets some page data, it waits for 2 seconds here before it yields an ERN. So it makes sense for us to do this, but it's kind of weird that we do it here inside of the Flickr tag search. Seems like we're mixing in like a responsibility down in the code where it's not supposed to be. It would be nicer if these two were separate things. So what we're going to do is that we're going to create a function that takes an iterator and it returns a delayed iterator. Alright, so let's see how we do this. I need a bit smaller text. Sorry, mobile users. Let's create a new function that we just call function delayed. Boom, boom. And it's going to take an iterator. And it's going to take a delay milliseconds. And because in functional programming, this order is more like the customary thing to do. Okay, this is a bit wrong. It's actually an iterable that we want. And we want this to return a delayed version of the iterable. So we're going to just return an object. And again, to do this, we want to do like return an object that has a property that is kind of named with a symbol that is called async iterator. And this is supposed to be a function that creates the delayed iterator for anyone that needs it. So the first thing that we want to do is to grab the inner iterator of the iterable that we're going to create a delayed version of. So const iterator, we grab the inner iterable that we're going to transform, and that is again going to have a property called symbol.asyncIterator, and that's a function that creates an iterator for us. So we call that, and now we're going to have the iterator here. We're going to keep this iterator in this closure, and we're going to create the new iterable, return the new iterable that we, the delayed iterable. Actually, I'm going to, just for pedagogical purposes, I'm going to const delayed iterable. Next is a function that is supposed to give us the next item in line. And this is just going to grab the iterate call next of the original iterator dot next, but it's going to delay it. So all we're going to do is delay, going to call that with the delay milliseconds, wow, and then we're going to wait for that, and once that delay is over, we're going to call iterator next, and this is what we're going to return. I need to actually extract Flickr tags, the delay thing, out of Flickr tag search. I'm going to copy this because, you know, delays is not defined. I'm going to put that here. And this one is now defined. I see that this resolved after seconds, so actually let's just go run with that and call this delay seconds. You edited this notebook since publishing. I'm actually gonna, fork this, otherwise we are going to be in trouble. Or in trouble, I would overwrite the code of the last episode, and that would probably confuse the people watching that episode. And you're gonna find a link to this notebook in the episode description, and you can also just fork it like I did here to play around with it yourself. Like, observable, oh, it's amazing. Anyway, back to the code, delay seconds, this delay milliseconds is no longer true. I'm gonna delay seconds there. Hit shift enter to run that, and now it seems to compile. Let's see if this works. Let's go to Flickr tag search and throw out the delay parts of it. I'm going to throw out the delay there. And yeah, I'm gonna run that, and it's going to go crazy. So this cat's here, we now want to create a delayed version of that. Delayed. Come on, see if this works. Ow, boom! Cannot read property symbol async iterator of undefined. That's peculiar. Oh, I'm dumb, that's the problem. I created this variable to make it more easily understandable what was happening, and then I forgot to actually return it, so it confused us. I'm gonna return the delayed iterable, see if that gives us some progress. It did not though, it still breaks. Cannot read symbol
a sync iterator of undefined.
So cats is undefined. That means that delayed is returning undefined. But it seems to me like this is distinctly not undefined. How is that possible? Oh, you know what? This error is actually... I'm probably looking at the wrong thing here. Because I was believing that this is the undefined thing. But looking at these, it's probably this one that is wrong. See the iterable? The delayed function needs an argument for how many delayed seconds, actually. So delayed, we need to go delayed 2 seconds. Let's see if this works. Oh! Solved it! I was dumb, but then I was smart. That is truly the experience of being a software developer. This is actually just some crap. I think I can remove this. Hang on, this is no longer code for using a sync generator. It's gonna like, well, what are we gonna call this episode? We're gonna call it higher order iterators in JavaScript. Bam. And I'm going to publish that so that it's available to you fine people. So what we did here today was we extracted this 2 second delay that every picture has out of the Flickr tag search, and we created this higher order iterator function, a function that takes an iterable and it transforms that and creates a new iterator that is delayed, or a new iterable that is delayed. We could, like, I think it's going to be confusing if I name this episode higher order iterables, but that's actually what it is. Takes an iterable and returns a new iterable that has some properties, such as it being delayed. This is very similar to how array.map works and how array.filter works. It creates, takes an array, you call a function on it, such as filter, and it returns a filtered array. So in the same way here, we take an iterator and then we return a delayed iterator. That's why it's called higher order. It's basically, could call it like a meta iterator. In the next episode, I'm going to explore this a little bit more and trying to have some more advanced examples. There's a lot of things that we can do here. As async iterators are built into JavaScript, we're probably going to see a few big libraries handling this in the future. I don't know if maybe there already are. I have no idea. If you know, please post a comment down below. Speaking of which, that's it. If you have any comments or questions or confusions, and confusions are likely, then please post them down below and I will try to answer. Or if you feel like supporting the show, you can become a patron, and that gives you access to the Fun Forum, which is a fun and friendly place where we have discussions with other programmers, and I hang out there a lot. So if you feel like doing that it's very welcome. It's a very nice place. If you already are a patron, there is a link to a dedicated topic for this specific video on the Fun Forum. You can find a link to that one in the episode description. And if you're thinking about adding some real-time communication or collaboration to your app, do check out Pusher, our sponsor, and say hi. You have just watched an episode of Fun Function. I release these every Monday morning, 0800 GMT. You can subscribe here so that you don't miss it, or you can watch another episode right now by clicking here. I am MPJ. Until next Monday morning, stay curious.